the light of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
The light of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
The light of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Victorious. truly necessary sin of Adam, destroyed completely by the death of Christ. Oh, happy fault that earned so great, so glorious a Redeemer. Oh, truly blessed night, worthy alone to know the time and hour when Christ rose from the underworld. This is the night of which it is written, the night shall be as bright as day. Dazzling is the night for me, and fullness sadness. The sanctifying power of this night dispels wickedness, washes faults away, restores innocence to the fallen, and joy to mourners. Drives out hatred, fosters concord, and brings down the mighty. On this your night of grace, O Holy Father, accept this candle, a solemn offering, the work of bees and of your servant's hands, an evening sacrifice of praise, this gift from your most holy church. But now we know the praises of this pillar, which glows with fire, ignites for God's honor. A fire into many flames divided, yet never dimmed by sharing of its light. For it is fed by melting wax, drawn out by mother bees, to build a torch so precious. Oh, truly blessed night, when things of heaven are wed to those of earth, and divine to the human. Therefore, O Lord, we pray you that this candle, hallowed to the honor of your name, may persevere undimmed to overcome the darkness of this night. Receive it as a pleasing fragrance, and let it mingle with the lights of heaven. May this flame be found still burning by the morning star, the one morning star who never sets, Christ your Son, who coming back from death storming, has shed his peaceful light on humanity, and lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen.
Dear brethren, now that we have begun our solemn vigil, let us listen with quiet hearts to the word of God. Let us meditate on how God in times past saved his people, and in these, the last days, has sent us his Son as our Redeemer. Let us pray that our God may complete this paschal work of salvation by the fullness of redemption.
A reading from the book of Genesis. In the beginning, when God created the heavens and the earth was a formless wasteland, and darkness covered the abyss, while a mighty wind swept over the waters. Then God said, "Let there be light," and there was light. God saw how good the light was. God then separated the light from the darkness. God called the light day, and the darkness he called night. Thus evening came and morning followed the first day. Then God said, "Let there be a dome in the middle of the waters to separate one body of water from the other." And so it happened. God made the dome, and it separated the water above the dome from the water below it. God called the dome the sky. Evening came and morning followed the second day. Then God said, "Let the water under the sky be gathered into a single basin, so that the dry land may appear." And so it happened. The water under the sky was gathered into its basin, and the dry land appeared. God called the dry land the earth, and the basin of water he called the sea. God saw how good it was. Then God said, "Let the earth bring forth vegetation, every kind of plant that bears seed, and every kind of fruit tree on the earth that bears fruit with its seed in it." And so it happened. The earth brought forth every kind of plant that bears seed, and every kind of fruit tree on earth that bears fruit with its seed in it. God saw how good it was. Evening came and morning followed the third day. Then God said, "Let there be lights in the dome of the sky to separate day from night. Let them mark the fixed times, the days and the years, and serve as luminaries in the dome of the sky to shed light upon the earth." And so it happened. God made the two great lights, the greater one to govern the day and the lesser one to govern the night. And he made the stars. God set them in the dome of the sky to shed light upon the earth, to govern the day and the night, and to separate the light from the darkness. God saw how good it was. Evening came, and morning followed the fourth day. Then God said, "Let the water teem with an abundance of living creatures, and on earth let birds fly beneath the dome of the sky." And so it happened. God created the great sea monsters and all kinds of swimming creatures with which the waters teems, and all kinds of winged birds. God saw how good it was, and God blessed them, saying, "Be fertile, multiply, and fill the water of the seas, and let the birds multiply on the earth." Evening came, and morning followed the fifth day. Then God said, "Let the earth bring forth all kinds of creatures, cattle, creeping things, and wild animals of all kinds." And so it happened. God made all kinds of wild animals, all kinds of cattle, and all kinds of creeping things of the earth. God saw how good it was. Then God said, "Let us make man in our image, after our likeness. Let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, the birds of the air, and the cattle, and over all wild animals and all creatures that crawl on the ground." God created man in his image. In the image of God, he created him. Male and female, he created them. God blessed them, saying, "Be fertile and multiply. Fill the earth and subdue it. Have dominion over the fish of the sea, the birds of the air, and all the living things that move on the earth." God also said, "See, I give you every seed-bearing plant all over the earth, and every tree that has seed-bearing fruit on it to be your food. And to all the animals of the land, all the birds of the air, and all the living creatures that crawl on the ground, I give all the green plants for food." And so it happened. God looked at everything he had made, and he found it very good. Evening came, and morning followed the sixth day. Thus the heavens and the earth and all their array were completed. Since on the seventh day God was finished with the work he had been doing, he rested on the seventh day from all the work he had undertaken. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of Exodus. The Lord said to Moses, "Why are you crying out to me? Tell the Israelites to go forward, and you lift up your staff, and with hand outstretched over the sea, split the sea in two, that the Israelites may pass through it on dry land. But I will make the Egyptians so obstinate that they will go in after them. Then I will receive glory through Pharaoh and all his army, his chariots and charioteers. The Egyptians shall know that I am the Lord when I receive glory through Pharaoh and his chariots and charioteers." The angel of God, who had been leading Israel's camp, now moved and went around behind them. The column of cloud also, leaving the front, took up its place behind them, so that it came between the camp of the Egyptians and that of Israel. But the cloud now became dark, and thus the night passed without the rival camps coming any closer together all night long. Then Moses stretched out his hand over the sea, and the Lord swept the sea with a strong east wind throughout the night, and so turned it into dry land. When the water was thus divided, the Israelites marched into the midst of the sea on dry land, with the water like a wall to their right and to their left. The Egyptians followed in pursuit, while Pharaoh's horses and charioteers went after them, right into the midst of the sea. In the night watch, just before dawn, the Lord cast through the column of the fiery cloud upon the Egyptian force a glance that threw it into a panic, and he so clogged their chariot wheels that they could hardly drive. With that, the Egyptians sounded the retreat before Israel, because the Lord was fighting for them against the Egyptians. Then the Lord told Moses, "Stretch out your hand over the sea, that the water may flow back upon the Egyptians, upon their chariots and their charioteers." So Moses stretched out his hand over the sea, and at dawn the sea flowed back to its normal depth. The Egyptians were fleeing head on toward the sea when the Lord hurled them into its midst. As the water flowed back, it covered the chariots and the charioteers of Pharaoh's whole army, which had followed the Israelites into the sea. Not a single one of them escaped, but the Israelites had marched on dry land through the midst of the sea, with the water like a wall to their right and to their left. Thus the Lord saved Israel on that day from the power of the Egyptians. When Israel saw the Egyptians lying dead on the seashore, and beheld the great power that the Lord had shown against the Egyptians, they feared the Lord and believed in him and in his servant Moses. Then Moses and the Israelites sang this song to the Lord. "I will sing to the Lord, for he is gloriously triumphant. Horse and chariot he has cast into the sea." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
bestowed on a single people, freeing them from Pharaoh's persecution by the power of your right hand. Now you bring about as the salvation of the nations through the waters of rebirth. Grant, we pray, that the whole world may become children of Abraham and inherit the dignity of Israel's birthright. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
A reading from the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, all you who are thirsty, come to the water. You who have no money, come, receive grain and eat. Come without paying and without cost. Drink wine and milk. Why spend your money for what is not bread, your wages for what fails to satisfy? Heed me, and you shall eat well. You shall delight in rich fare. Come to me heedfully, listen, that you may have life. I will renew with you the everlasting covenant that benefits assured to David, as I made him a witness to the peoples, a leader and commander of nations. So shall you summon a nation you knew not, and nations that knew you not shall run to you, because of the Lord your God, the Holy One of Israel, who has glorified you. Seek the Lord while he may be found. Call him while he is near. Let the scoundrel forsake his way, and the wicked man his thoughts. Let him turn to the Lord for mercy, to our God, who is generous in forgiving. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, and your ways may my ways, says the Lord. As high as the heavens are above the earth, so high are my ways above your ways, and my thoughts above your thoughts. For just as from the heavens the rain and snow come down and do not return there till they have watered the earth, making it fertile and fruitful, giving seed to the one who sows and bread to the one who eats, so shall my word be that goes forth from my mouth. My word shall not return to me void, but shall do my will, achieving the end for which I sent it. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
sole hope of the world, who by the preaching of your prophets unveiled the mysteries of this present age, graciously increase the longing of your people, for only at the prompting of your grace do the faithful progress in any kind of virtue, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Sisters, are you unaware that we who are baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? We were indeed buried with him through baptism into death, so that, just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live in newness of life. For if we have grown into union with him through a death like his, we shall also be united with him in the resurrection. We know that our old self was crucified with him, so that our sinful body might be done away with, that we might no longer be in slavery to sin. For a dead person has been absolved from sin. If then we have died with Christ, we believe that we shall also live with him. We know that Christ, raised from the dead, dies no more. Death no longer has power over him. As to his death, he died to sin once and for all. As to his life, he lives for God. Consequently, you too must think of yourselves as being dead to sin and living for God in Christ Jesus, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
After the Sabbath, as the first day of the week was dawning, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary came to see the tomb. And behold, there was a great earthquake, for an angel of the Lord descended from heaven, approached, rolled back the stone, and sat upon it. His appearance was like lightning, and his clothing was white as snow. The guards were shaken with fear of him and became like dead men. Then the angel said to the women in reply, "Do not be afraid. I know that you are seeking Jesus the crucified. He is not here, for he has been raised, just as he said. Come and see the place where he lay. Then go quickly and tell his disciples he has been raised from the dead. And he is going before you to Galilee. There you will see him. Behold, I have told you." Then they went quickly away from the tomb, fearful yet overjoyed, and ran to announce this to his disciples. And behold, Jesus met them on their way and greeted them. They approached, embraced his feet, and did him homage. Then Jesus said to them, "Do not be afraid. Go tell my brothers to go to Galilee, and there they will see me." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise
to you, Lord Jesus Christ. It's only fitting that on today, the Easter Vigil and Easter Sunday, that I preach on the book of Exodus. Okay, so there's a reason for my madness, as always. There's something that I want to point out to you, something that that kind of stuck with me for a very long time. But before we get it to that part, let's go over the second reading. So it was the reading after the very long creation story. And it's about the crossing of the Red Sea. That's where I want to start this evening. The people, the Hebrew people at this time, have grumbled against Moses. They do a lot of grumbling in the book of Exodus, a lot of whining, a lot of complaining. I can relate to that. Maybe you can too, especially at this time. A lot of complaining. And so they complained when they were enslaved by the Egyptians. And now they're complaining as Moses is freeing them. God is rescuing them because they were complaining. So God heard their cries and answered their prayers. And so Moses is leading them out. But now they get to this Red Sea. And then they look behind and they see the Egyptians pursuing them. And so they start complaining again. "Have you took us out here to let us die?" You know, those are the things that they're saying to Moses. And then that's where our first reading, our second reading here picks up. Because it starts off with the line, "The Lord said to Moses, why are you crying out to me?" Okay, Moses is crying out to the Lord because the Hebrew people are complaining to Moses that they brought him out to the Red Sea to have him killed. But the next line is a line that will blow you away. Think about this. The Lord says to Moses, "Tell the Israelites to go forward, and you lift up your staff with hand outstretched over the sea. Split the sea in two." Did you catch what I'm getting at? What's the first thing that has to happen? The Hebrew people have to go into the water first, while it's still there. See, we always have the image of the famous movie Ten Commandments. So the movie shows the water splitting and then the people going in. But that's not what Scripture tells us. The first command is to have them go forward. Go into the water while it's still there. And then Moses will stretch out his hand and the sea split in two. See, do you see where I'm getting at? You have to go into the fear first. You have to trust in the Lord, accept the fear, embrace the fear, and go forward with the Lord. The waters don't split apart until the Israelites trust in him and proceed to go in, believing that God will take care of them. Out of all the complaining that we are doing and all the grumbling and all the real struggles that we have, I mean, let's face it, some people are really dealing with heavy stuff right now. And then a lot of us, like myself, are dealing with things like, oh, I can't golf, okay? And I'm complaining about that. But there are real people out there with real problems. Health problems or financial problems. And then there's us complaining and grumbling over the little things. But in all this situation right now, we have to accept the fact that we are scared, to grab the Lord by the hand and proceed forward. Because now getting to the New Testament, and it is Easter, so I do have to talk about the New Testament, but get now to the disciples. These men on Good Friday betrayed Jesus, denied Jesus 3 times, and the rest of them went away hiding on Good Friday. Now these same men are going to now accept their fear and are now going to go out into the world. They're going to be sent by Christ. As we're going to hear over the next really couple of weeks, Jesus calling the disciples to himself once again and sending them out. So just like the Hebrew people had to go into the Red Sea while the water was still there, trusting that God is going to take care of them, now he's going to send the disciples out into the chaotic world to trust in them, that God is going to be with them along the way. Even as they approach their martyrdom, that they proceed with confidence because they know something great is coming. That's what Easter Sunday is all about. To take our fears, to take our worries, to go with our Lord, and to know that he has something great for us. We just don't know what it's like. We don't know what it is. We haven't experienced it yet. We never experienced what divine and eternal life is. But that's what our Lord wants to give us. But sometimes it's scary to go in that direction. And right now it's scary to walk with our Lord in these uncertain times. But Easter, for us, is just right around the corner. God's blessings, God's sanctification, God's holiness, and all this is going to come out at some point. Hold the hand of God. Proceed forward. And let him guide you in your fear. May God bless you and happy Easter.
Let us pray. O God, who by invisible power accomplished a wondrous effect through sacramental signs, and in whom many ways have prepared water in your creation to show forth the grace of baptism. O God, whose spirit in the first moments of the world's creation hovered over the waters, so that the very substance of water would even then take to itself the power to sanctify. O God, who by the outpouring of the flood foreshadowed the regeneration, so that from the mystery of one and the same element of water would come an end to vice and the beginning of virtue. O God, who caused the children of Abraham to pass dry shod through the Red Sea, so that the chosen people set free from slavery to Pharaoh would prefigure the people of the baptized. O God, whose Son, baptized by John in the waters of the Jordan, was anointed by the Holy Spirit as he hung upon the cross, gave forth water from his side along with blood, and after his resurrection commanded his disciples, go forth, teach all nations, baptize them in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Look now, we pray, upon the face of your church, and graciously unseal for her the fountain of baptism. May this water receive by the Holy Spirit the grace of your only begotten Son, so that the human nature created in your image and washed clean through the sacrament of baptism from all the squalor of the life of old, may be found worthy to rise to the life of newborn children through water and the Holy Spirit. May the power of the Holy Spirit, O Lord, we pray, come down to your Son into the fullness of this font, so that all who have been buried with Christ by baptism into death may rise again to life with him who lives and reigns with you in unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Amen. Dear brethren, through the Paschal mystery we have been buried with Christ in baptism, so that we may walk with him in newness of life. And so now that our Lenten observance is concluded, let us renew the promises of holy baptism, by which we once renounced Satan and his works, and promised to serve God in the Holy Catholic Church. And so I ask you, do you renounce Satan?
I do.
And all his works?
I do.
And all his empty show? Do you believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth?
I do.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death and was buried, rose again from the dead, and is seated at the right hand of the Father?
I do.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting?
I do.
And may Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has given you new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, bestow on us forgiveness of our sins. Keep us by his grace in Christ Jesus our Lord for eternal life. Amen.
Amen.
We may proclaim the saving event of Easter, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the nations of this world, that the kingdom of the risen Lord may spread through all societies and culture, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have been baptized at this time, that freed from the slavery of sin, they will live the new life of the risen Christ, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For this worshiping community, that we will share the joyous news of the resurrection with those we meet, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who suffer from the coronavirus, for their families, and those who provide care and comfort to the suffering, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the faithful departed, that having died with Christ, they will return to life with him, especially the deceased parishioners of St. Joseph the Worker Parish, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
for all the prayers that we hold in the silence of our hearts, and for all our intentions, spoken and unspoken. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We also pray for all the deceased members of the former parishioners of St. Charles Borromeo, as well as our former alumni, and for our former students at Marian Catholic High School. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, may you answer these prayers and petitions of ours in accordance with your will, which we make through Christ our Lord. Amen. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands for the praise and joy of his name, for our good, and the good of his holy church.
Accept, we ask, O Lord, the prayers of your people with the sacrificial offerings, that what has begun in the Paschal mysteries may by the working of your power bring us to the healing of eternity, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Give them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It's right and just.
It's truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to proclaim you, O Lord. But on this night, above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he has destroyed our death, and by rising, restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them, the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. The time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, given thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, And once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaken of the body and blood of Christ, we be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the whole world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Alfred, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us, O Lord, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout all the ages, we may merit to be coheirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the hope of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant our peace and unity, in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Take away.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, my soul shall be healed. Sacrament, one in mind and heart, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow your heads for the blessing. May Almighty God bless you through today's Easter solemnity, and in his compassion defend you from every assault of sin.
Amen.
And may he who restores you to eternal life in the resurrection of his only begotten endow you with the prize of immortality. Now that the days of the Lord's Passion have drawn to a close, may you celebrate the gladness of the Paschal Feast. Come with Christ's help and exultant in spirit to whose feasts that are celebrating eternal joy.
Amen.
May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever. Amen.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended. Alleluia. Alleluia.